गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड
मॉर्निंग। अरे
गुड
हु इज
मॉर्निंग।
दिस? माय लाइफ माय रूल्स। हु इज दिस? ओके, शैल वी स्टार्ट नाउ? Till now only 14 has come. All are sleeping only. Okay. So we have done up to what is refraction, what is the cause of refraction, what will happen when the ray goes from rarer to denser or from denser to rarer. And then refractive index. So we were discussing the refractive index of one medium with respect to other medium, no? By that time only meeting was over. So refractive index we have discussed already. Refractive index of second medium, suppose of medium B with respect to A. What was that? It is absolute refractive index of B over absolute refractive index of A. Or it can be speed of light in A by speed of light in B. Till here we have done? Yes? What all? Forgot or what?
Yes, sir. Till here
yes,
we have
sir.
Done, sir.
Till here we have done. Now, you know, this speed of light is given by the product of frequency and wavelength. So, speed of light in A, we can say frequency into wavelength of light in A. And speed of light in B will be frequency into wavelength of light in B. As there is no change in the frequency. When light goes from one medium to other, frequency will remain same. Its velocity will change. Velocity may increase, may decrease, depending on from which medium it is going to which medium. If it is going from denser to rarer, velocity of light will increase. Rarer to denser, velocity or speed of light will decrease. Similarly, if velocity increases, this wavelength will also increase, but frequency remains unchanged. So if light is going from denser to rarer, speed increases, wavelength also increases. If light is going from rarer to denser, speed decreases, naturally wavelength also decreases. So the ratio of these two will be lambda A above lambda B. So it can be also given by the ratio of wavelength. So this is the relation of refractive index of one medium with respect to other medium. It can be given in terms of refractive index. It can be given in terms of the ratio of the speed of light. It can be expressed in terms of wavelength of light in two mediums. So refractive index of one medium with respect to other may be more than one or may be less than one. It has got both the value. This refractive index of B with respect to A, this can be more than one, it can be less than one, depending on the two medium. For example, suppose the speed of light in water, glass, and diamond. is 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And 1.4 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Find, first we are asked, refractive index of diamond with respect to glass. Refractive index of water with respect to glass. Speed of light in a medium of refractive index 1.2. Okay, suppose we have the questions we are asked. Or some more, maybe. Wavelength of light in glass, if its frequency in air be 5 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Glass and water, both you can find. Okay, only glass. If you want one more, wavelength of light in glass, if its wavelength in diamond be or water, wavelength in water be 500 nanometers. So first one is refractive index of diamond with respect to glass.
1.4.
Diamond with respect to glass, okay, maybe 1.4. Very good. So refractive index of diamond with respect to glass. As speed is given, so we'll express in terms of speed. So it may be speed of light in glass over speed of light in diamond. So speed of light in glass is 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second by 1.4 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Okay, so whatever it is coming. Ten by seven, it will come. So 1.44. No. So 1.44 will be 1.43. You can say. So 1.43 will be the refractive index of diamond with respect to glass. Now, second one is refractive index of water with respect to glass.
0.87 sir.
0.8
8 by 9. Yes sir, 8 by 9.
Yes, it will come 8 by 9. Very good. So it is coming less than 1. That means the refractive index of, when we find the refractive index of one medium with respect to other, it may be more than 1, it may be less than 1 also. But absolute refractive index of any medium will never be less than 1. Because speed of light in that particular medium will always be less than speed of light in vacuum. So second one is, refractive index of water with respect to glass. The speed of light in glass by speed of light in water. So 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second by 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So it will become 8 over 9. So that you can find. 0.89 something you will get. Now next one is the speed of light in a medium of refractive index 1.2.
Say 2.5 into 10 power 8.
Or 8 meter.
Yes, 2.5 into 10 to the power 8. Now here, the speed of light in a medium of refractive index 1.2, that is absolute refractive index you are given. So in this case, refractive index of mu m, that is given 1.2. So speed of light in medium will become speed of light in vacuum by refractive index of medium. And speed of light in vacuum, if not given, you are supposed to know. So it is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second by 1.2. Okay, now fourth one is wavelength of light in glass if its frequency in air is this much. So here what will be, whether frequency is given in air or in that particular medium, frequency does not change. So here frequency is given in air, that means same frequency will be in glass also. So frequency in air or frequency in glass will be same. That you are given 5 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. As you know, C is n lambda. So this lambda will be speed of light in glass over frequency. Whether it is in air or glass, same thing. The speed of light in glass we are given 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And frequency you are given 5 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Hertz means per second. So per second will cancel. So answer will come in meter. 2 by 5. How much? 0.4. Into 10 to the power. This one will go up. So minus 6. So we say 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter will be the frequency, sorry, wavelength of light in glass, whose frequency is this much. Now the last one. Last one is wavelength of light in glass. If wavelength in water you are given, so we'll compare the wavelength. So we are given in glass and water, so we can find the refractive index. Either you can say water with respect to glass, that will be wavelength of light in glass over wavelength of light in water. Someone can say, okay, no, I will take refractive index of glass with respect to water, can be speed of light in water over speed of light in glass, by wavelength of light in water by wavelength of light in glass. You can use anything, anyone. And this one you have calculated, you can use that. Otherwise, we will use these two. So wavelength of light in glass you are asked and water you are given. You may use these two or you may use this one. And we have got this one, 8 by 9, 500 nanometer. Or someone can say, okay, I will use this one only. So lambda G over 500 nanometer will be 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second by 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And this one we have calculated, so you can use this or you can calculate this way as the speed of light in both medium you are knowing. So lambda G will be 44.4 nanometer. So this will be 5.
Sir, when we use
yes
0.9, we will use 0.88, the answer will come 440.
No, then it will change. You are not supposed to use decimal fraction when you are using the same. So this one, like this you have to write. When we got, okay, refractive index of water with respect to glass, 8 by 9 equal to that, we will give in answer decimal fraction. But when again you are using refractive index of water with respect to glass in some other expression, this is the exact one. So we are supposed to use 8 by 9. You are not supposed to use 0.89 or 88, whatever you have got. not factors we have to factors on which speed of light depends. Speed of light of any wavelength or any color or any electromagnetic wave, whether it is light, whether it is X-ray, whether it is ultraviolet ray, infrared ray, all have got the same speed in vacuum or in air. So speed of light of different color or different wavelength. Different color means here wavelength. Is same in vacuum or in air. And this value is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Whether it is light, whether it is green light, whether it is violet light, all will have same speed. So frequently one mass question it is asked, which color will travel fast in vacuum or in air? So answer will be the speed of all the color will be same. But in any other medium, speed depend on wavelength also. In any other medium, speed of light increasing wavelength. So if wavelength of light is more, its speed will be also more. So from here what we are getting? Speed of violet is minimum and that of red in any other medium, not in air. In any medium other than air or vacuum is maximum. So speed of light is not same for different color. So speed of light of red color will be maximum, whereas violet, which has got minimum wavelength, will be minimum. So these are the factors, means in different medium what will happen speed, what will be the speed of light of any color, sometime it is asked, which one will travel faster, green or red in glass. So answer will be red will travel faster in glass. Which one will travel faster, green or red in vacuum? Both will travel with same speed. Now factors on which refractive index of any medium depends. or only refractive index, you can say, not any medium. It may be refractive index of one medium with respect to other. Or let us see one, any medium, only, no problem. So directly one will discuss one medium, then ratio will also be on the same factor. So as we know, speed of light in vacuum or in air is same for all the wavelengths. But in other medium, when we go, it is different. So when speed changes, when it goes from one medium to other, and the change is not same for all the wavelengths. So there will be two factors only. One will be nature of the medium. So indirectly we say optical density of medium. How much dense the medium is. If the medium is optically denser, naturally speed of light will be less. And if the speed of light is less, means refractive index is more. Because it is given by the ratio of the speed of light only. So it will depend on, because refractive index of any medium is the speed of light in vacuum by speed of light in that medium. So the speed of light in that medium is less, refractive index will be more. Now you know this speed depends on two things. One is the nature of the medium, and just now we have discussed it depends on wavelength also. So indirectly, refractive index will depend on wavelength also. If you are comparing refractive index of the two medium, then nature of both the medium will write, that is refractive index of A with respect to B if we are finding. Then nature of both the medium will write. Now as we know, speed of red is maximum. So here if you take red light, speed will be maximum. So naturally refractive index will be minimum. So what does it mean? Refractive index of red is minimum and refractive index for same medium is maximum for violet. So refractive index of any medium decreases with increasing wavelength of incident light. So we say refractive index of violet is maximum, refractive index of any medium. Is maximum for violet. Well, the speed of light is a minimum for violet. Violet light will travel very slow. Very slow doesn't mean that you will be able to detect it. Very slow means if it is one is 3 × 10^8 meter per second, other may be 2.9999999 like that 6 meter per second. or 8 meter per second. So we will not be able to detect very easily. So refractive index of any medium is maximum for violet and minimum for red. Red means here 8,000 angstrom is red or 800 nanometer. The wavelength is 800 nanometer, violet means 4,000 angstrom or 400 nanometer. Your wavelength is minimum for violet. Visible light is from 4,000 to 8,000. So these are the factors on which refractive index depend. So anywhere this refractive index comes, the factor, so directly these are the two factors on which will affect the refractive index. Okay, refractive index depend on the nature of medium, that is refractive index for glass, what we have calculated just now, 1.5. It is, we call it for mean ray, that is yellow light. For different color, it will be slightly varying. It may be 1.4999 like that for violet, and it may be 1.500002 for red. So this much variation, not much more variation will be there, but there will be variation. Now, laws of refraction. So these laws we have already done in class 8. So one law is same as reflection. And what is that? Incident ray, refracted ray, and normal at the point of incidence. All lie in same plane. So first law is incident ray refracted ray and normal at the point of incidence. All lie in same plane. So it is same as reflection only. In place of reflected ray here, refracted ray will come. So it is not the difference. Second law, this is also known as Snell's law. This law says, it is written in your book also, no problem. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence that we call sine I in first medium to the sine of angle of refraction sine R that we call second medium in which ray is going after refraction. Generally, we say second medium. You can write A, medium B, no problem. Second medium is a constant known as refractive index of medium with respect to first medium. So we say mathematically we say it is this sine I over sine R is refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. Point number two, first line is the ratio of sine, S-I-N-E. Sine cos 10, what you are writing? The full name is sine, S-I-N-E. Sine of angle of incidence. That is symbolically we write sine I. In first medium. To the sine of angle of refraction, sine R, in second medium is a constant. And this constant we call, known as refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. That will be afterwards, critical angle afterwards. So this is sine I by sine R is refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. So what does it mean? Where so suppose so if this is I, this is R, this is medium 1, this is medium 2, here speed of light in this medium is C1, speed of light in this medium is C2, wavelength of light in this medium is lambda 1, wavelength of light in this medium is lambda 2. Then what will be, if C2 will be more than C1, it will bend towards this one, that is. So if refractive index, absolute refractive index is mu 2, absolute refractive index of this medium is mu 1. Then according to Snell's law, what can be written? So according to Snell's law, we can write, is sine I over sine R active index of second with respect to
center of gravity parallel to
can be in different form
towards the
so can be in terms of wavelength sorry in terms of speed C1 by C2 and we have expressed
bar of single force can be replaced
as After this, already we have discussed what is coming. Only this part is coming from Snell's law.
Yeah.
Will mic is on? Mic off. Mute it. Now, from this also, it is very clear. If refractive index of, suppose this one mu 2 is more than mu 1, naturally I will be more than R. Well, value of sine increases when we go up from 0 degree to 90 degree, the value of sine will also increase. Sine 0, 0, sine 91. In cos, it is reverse. So here, as it is coming sine, that means if this one is more, this one will be also more. Naturally, if the speed of light in first medium is more than that of second, then I is more than R, or in terms of wavelength. So from here also it is very clear, if light is going from rarer to denser, that is C2 is less, then R will be less than I. Just reverse, if this one is more than this, if C2 is more than C1, naturally R will be more than I. So in this figure, this C2 is less than C1. If it is more than C1, what will happen? So this is R, this one will be I. So if this is C2, this is C1, and C2 is more than C1, we went away from the normal. From denser to rarer, from this relation again, it is coming same thing. Now, in this case, this is the deviation. In this case, this is the deviation. Now, if this, what are the conditions for the ray going undeviated, and what are the factors on which delta depends?
Sir, time up.
So, conditions under which goes undeviated. Already we have discussed in class 7, in class 8. So what are the two conditions? One is, if the ray is incident normally. This is first medium, this is second medium. So whatever the medium may be, whether it is going from air to diamond, diamond means densest medium, we can say, densest optical medium is diamond. Time is up, yeah, that you know. So we'll finish. Now today is the last class. After that, you will get break. Now second one is what? What is the condition? Okay, wait. So it will be, if this is C1, this is C2, first medium, this is second medium. If C2 is equal to C1, that is mu 2 is equal to mu 1, then whatever the angle of incidence, So here I will be equal to R, naturally delta will be 0. So these are the two conditions. If the ray is incident normally, whatever the medium may be. Second is, if the nature of the two medium or the refractive index of the two medium is same. Here the example is, this is glass and benzene at a particular temperature. At normal temperature, refractive index of benzene is little more than that of glass. So when temperature increases, the refractive index of benzene decreases. At a particular temperature, it will become equal to glass. Okay, one more factor we forgot there. Temperature also affects. So temperature means indirectly nature of the medium only. So nature and temperature, that first factor you have written, the factors on which refractive index depend, we can write nature and temperature also. So with this we will finish the factors on deviation. Just we will read from the book. One will be the angle of incidence. As here we say, angle of incidence 0, deviation also 0. When angle of incidence increases, here angle of incidence is more, deviation is more. If angle of incidence is like this, what will be? It will go undeviated. And the second and third factor will be same as refractive index. So if you are asked factors on which delta depend, so first will be angle of incidence. So delta increases with I. And second and third factor will be same as refractive index. Well, it will depend on refractive index also. Here, if refractive index is same, no deviation. So if the difference of these two refractive index is more, deviation will also be more. So it will depend on refractive index of the two medium. Indirectly, refractive index depend on nature and color and wavelength. Okay, so the points are given in your book, you will learn. So from tomorrow, we will not have any class. We will have a break, maybe for whatever days may be. Let us, it will be decided by father. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.